Because how in the hell else are you ever going to find your way through the ins and outs in this mega world that we call the internet and all the things that are going along with it to get to that Wonderland unless you're following somebody who already kind of knows how to get there? Because again, Alice, if you're not following that white rabbit, how in the hell do you anticipate that you'll be able to find Wonderland? If you ain't show something, you just don't wanna be. You wanna be me, but you will never be as fresh as you be. Hey, what it do? What it do? What it do? It's your boy Q. And there ain't nothing left to do but to go ahead and get down and do what it do. Look, I'm excited, most of all because, like, it's been a little while since I've gotten a chance to do one of these. We've really hit, like, a really nice stride over on Mixer.com/YoBoyQ, which, by the way, if you're not following over there, you probably should. Just because we have a lot of fun every morning, starting at 6 o'clock Eastern time. But I've started to notice something as far as, I guess you could say, a trend that I've actually noticed for some time now. Because I have been streaming for a little while, you know, have a lot of friends that stream that I watch. And, you know, obviously one of the biggest things that every streamer talks about is networking, which we're actually going to break that down later because a lot of people are just really, really inefficiently networking. But that's for another video. But the problem that I've noticed is that we have so many people who have a goal in mind, this Wonderland, so to speak, that they want to get to. And they have no idea how to get there. And I'm not saying that that's a bad thing, right? Almost anybody who tries to really pick up any task, any hobby, they really don't have a way of knowing how to get from where they are to where they want to go, right? That's why we have things like coaches. We have things like mentors. These are the types of people who are able to teach us what we need to do personally in order to develop our craft to do what we want to do. Now, I'm not saying that you need to go looking for a streaming mentor or anything like that. This is actually something that you can do yourself. I want you to think back to a movie that a lot of us watched when we were kids, in Alice in Wonderland. Remember when Alice knew where she wanted to go, but she didn't know how to get there? How did she do it? She followed the white rabbit, right? The one who was late, he must be late. You need to find yourself a white rabbit. Because how in the hell else are you ever going to find your way through the ins and outs in this mega world that we call the internet and all the things that are going along with it to get to that Wonderland unless you're following somebody who already kind of knows how to get there? Now, I'm not talking about going and trying to talk to the biggest Mixer partner or the biggest Twitch partner or somebody on YouTube who has hundreds of thousands of subs if you're trying to build a YouTube channel. But I'm talking about finding that person who's just a little bit further ahead of you in the chase for the dream. Because again, Alice, if you're not following that white rabbit, how in the hell do you anticipate that you'll be able to find Wonderland? I feel like if we all take a second to be completely fair and honest with ourselves, and look across the board, across really all content creation mediums, you can think of a couple people that you know of who are just really doing this willy-nilly, fly by the seat of their pants, right? The only thing that they do is they jump on their computer, they hit the go live button, and they don't do anything else. Maybe these are people that you followed before you even became a content creator. And now that you are a content creator, you've seen yourself go from averaging less concurrent viewers to more concurrent viewers, to having more followers, and you see that they haven't really done anything, right? Don't get yourself caught in that position, because everyone's on this trip to Wonderland, but not everyone is willing to receive the directions from people who know where they're going, right? So I want you to think about this. I want you to take a second, because I know a lot of us who are content creators, we end up consuming a lot of content that isn't ours that we create, right? Whether it be watching other streamers when you're done, hanging out in chats before you start streaming itself, or even just watching a whole bunch of content on things like YouTube to try and get some ideas of what we want to create ourselves. But I want you to think about something. You can probably think of 2, 3, 4 people whose content you really enjoy, who maybe haven't quite hit that thousands upon thousands of subs and concurrent viewers and things like that. And those are the people who you want to start to chase after now, because they have just recently gone down the same road that you have. Because if you talk to somebody who got their Twitch career started, let's say 6, 7, 8 years ago, back then the game was different. There was only a couple thousands of streamers across the whole platform, let alone when you have a couple different games on the platform now who have tens of thousands of streamers just in that one category, right? So back then, it was easy to just hit the go live button 6, 7 days a week, stream 8, 10, 12, 14 hours, and eventually you would start to catch some traction by having people come into the stream and enjoying your content. But the problem is now that there's just way too many content creators. So you've got to find a way to really separate yourself from those who aren't willing to work. Because I do guarantee you this, there are plenty of those content creators out there who are not willing to work, okay? They just want to have the easy way out. They don't want to have to spend time editing videos once they're done streaming. They don't want to have to post clips up on a bunch of different social medias. For them, their dream job is to just simply post on Twitter and Instagram that they're about to go live and thousands of people show up into their chat. I'm just here to tell you that it don't happen like that, homie. Look, you need to find those people who are doing all of the other things, creating small clips, posting them on social medias, being really interactive in communities, whether it be on Reddit, YouTube, Discord, you name it. Because those are going to have to be the steps that you yourself have to recreate in order to be successful. Because the game is constantly changing. So the ones that we can really learn the most from are the people who took our next steps just a couple strides ago. Does that make sense? I'm sure that probably doesn't make sense to people. Look, we need to be following after the people who are only just a little bit ahead of us. I want you to think about this. If you're in a foot race, and let's say you're sitting in the middle of a pack, if you look all the way up to the front, that distance between you and them might seem so insurmountable that you just really almost lose a passion and a drive to really push hard to get there. But if you chase down the person that's right in front of you and pass him up, and then chase down the person that's right in front of them and pass them up, and so on and so forth, that gap between you and that person that you really want to end up passing up continues to get smaller and smaller and smaller, right? So the white rabbit that we're talking about is that person who's really just a little bit ahead of you in this content creation, because I think everyone has this thing twisted. They just hope that they're going to be able to show up and do the same thing that everybody else is doing and get the same exact results. Where the problem lies is that people don't take what they see from other people and make it their own, right? And it's really important that you have to realize what kind of content creator you are. Because if you're somebody like me who really just plays to have more for the entertainment value, yeah, maybe you're better than the average bear at the video game that you play, but you're not in that top 0.1% that's going to be competing and taking home money in tournaments every week, then there's really no point in watching those top play guys who are strictly competitors and try and emulate what they do in their stream. Because at the end of the day, that's not going to work for you. Just like if the vibe that you're trying to create in your channel is to be a little bit more laid back and fun loving, you're not going to watch, say, Adelor and try and figure out how to reproduce those rage mechanics, right? It just isn't going to fit. So what I'm going to challenge you guys today is I want you to think of two or three people who are in the same content creation chase that you are. And remember, we're not talking about the ones who are really close to your end goal. I'm talking about the ones who are just a step or two ahead of you. What is it that they are doing right now that allows them to see the success that we want to see? And I'm going to be honest with a lot of you guys. This is going to take a little bit of humbling, because that might mean you just need to message them and ask. It's okay to ask for help along the way. We all have mentors. We have people in our community that we reach out to that support us. So you might as have someone that you're chasing after as well. I hope you guys were able to take something away from this. If you wanted to keep this nice and short, again, if you could do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, leave a comment down below, and we will see you guys back on the next one. And of course, if you want to hang with us on stream, it's mixer.com/yoboyq. We are live just about every morning, start at 6 a.m. Eastern time. We run for a couple hours, so we hope to catch y'all there. It's your boy Q, signing out. Show something, you just don't wanna be, you wanna be me.
but you will never be.